everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Ashim Datta and today we are going to discuss about voltage commutated thyristorized chopper and its order code is 46546. So in this video we are going to discuss about its working. Now let's see the components that are used in this circuit. So this is the UJT, then there are IC741, then 7404, then 555. So these ICs are used for operational amplifier and for timer and for inverter gate. Then there are two SCR present, two pulse transformer PT1 and PT2, then two NPN transistor, then two SPST switches. These are the SPST switches. Then push to on off switch, then freewheeling diode, inductors and a bulb of 12 volt 5 watt. So we are using a bulb of 12 volt 5 watt as a load here, and this is the main power on off button. So this is the circuitry which is used for voltage commutated thyristorized chopper. Now let's see the experiment. So now for performing the experiment, firstly we have to keep the SPST switch position at off position. So this is the SPST switch 1, so we have to keep this switch position at off state, and this is the second SPST2 switch and we have to keep its position at off like this. Now we will switch on the kit and we will switch on the DSO. Now we will see the waveform on the DSO. So for that we will connect the cable to the channel 1, and now we will connect the ground terminal to the ground port, and now we will connect the other terminal to the A port like this. So here on the DSO you can see the waveform which we get at A port. Now similarly we will connect this port at E like this, and we can see the waveform on the DSO. So this is the waveform which we get, and you can cross check the waveforms from the manuals. Now we will check the waveform at F. So this is the waveform which we get at F. Now we will check the waveform at B. So here you can see that this is the waveform which we get at B port. Now we will check the waveform at C. So this is the waveform which we get at C port. Now we will check the waveform at D port. Just we have to shift this probe position from A to D, and we have to keep the ground at ground, and we can observe the waveform on the DSO. So this is the waveform which we get at D port. So that is how you can check the waveforms at different ports, and you can observe it on the DSO and you can cross check it from the manual. Now we will remove the connections. So firstly we will switch off the kit, and now we will remove the connections, and now we will again switch on the kit, and we have to press this switch once like this, and now we will keep the SPST2 switch at on position, and we can see the bulb is glowing, so our load is glowing. Now we will see the waveform along it, and now we will keep this SPST2 switch at off position, and now we will keep the SPST1 switch at on position, and now we will check the waveform along it like this. So this is the waveform which we get at GA, So we have to connect this probe at GA and the ground port at KA. Similarly, we can check the waveform at GM. So this is the waveform which we get at GM. And you can cross check these waveforms at the manual. So that is how we can perform the experiment and we can observe the waveforms on the DSO. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.